Hi, I'm Josh, and I'm so grateful that you have chosen to join me as I go through the 20 questions book tag. I have tagged myself to do this video, and I highly encourage the practice of self-tagging. So please do this video too if you think it looks interesting to you. Let's get right into it now. Question number one, how many books are too many books in a series? For that, I would say more than three books, and I have a significantly diminished chance of getting into that series. And when I sat down and thought about it, I don't think I've ever read more than three books in a series, unless you count, well, I suppose the Narnia series, but then we're getting into kind of middle grade stuff. As far as adult books go, maybe you would count The Lord of the Rings and The Hobbit as four books. Maybe you count it as two books, I don't know. But in general, I've never read anything longer than a trilogy. Question two, how do you feel about cliffhangers? Now, how I truly feel about cliffhangers. Question three, hardcover or paperback? I used to think that hardcovers were kind of the be-all and end-all in books. They were kind of the sturdier option, the better-looking option. But then I realized, as a reader, it's just way more comfortable to hold a paperback book. And so when I go out and purchase books now, I pretty much look for the paperbacks. I'll take comfort over style any day. Question four, favorite book. Now, I do have a couple of videos out there. If you search Josh Yaks favorite fiction, you'll see my top 10 favorite works of fiction. And if you search YouTube for Josh Yaks nonfiction, you'll see my favorite nonfiction books, the top 10 list of those as well. Now, I have read a couple of books since then that would get into my top 10 and bump out a couple that are already there. For instance, I just finished reading Anxious People by Frederick Bachman, and the next video I upload will probably be a video about that particular book. But my top three still remain the same for sure, and that is number three, we have Catch 22 by Joseph Heller. We have The Brothers K by David James Duncan. If you're a classics reader, you know what title that's riffing off of. And we have The Cider House Rules by John Irving as my number one favorite work of fiction of all time. Like I said, if you want to see the rest of my top 10, go and search for it on YouTube here. Question five, least favorite book. I've said for a while that the worst book I've read through to completion is Perdido Street Station by China Mieville, but I also recently read another book that really gives that some contention for the worst book I've ever read, and that is The Kite Runner by Khaled Hosseini. I've done videos about both of those books, so again, you can just search Josh Yaks with those book titles to find those if you're interested. Question six, love triangles, yes or no? No. Question seven, the most recent book you just couldn't finish. I was trying to think back, and it's been quite a long time since I've DNF'd a book, and I couldn't really remember which one was the last one I've DNF'd. In fact, I couldn't really recall any specific book titles of books I haven't finished. So that one is a little hard to answer, but there are a number of book series that I've read the first entire book in the series and then DNF the series. And in fact, that's going to be a subject of a future video at some point. I'll make a video about the series I've DNF'd and probably also include this popular series that I'm never going to start. But that'll be something for a month or two down the road. Question eight, a book you're currently reading. The book I'm currently getting through here is Dune by Frank Herbert. I am just over a quarter of the way through, and obviously it is a hugely popular, highly lauded science fiction book. Question nine, the last book you recommended to somebody, and that was probably The Fionnuala Tapestry by Guy Gavriel Kay, which is my very favorite high fantasy trilogy. And I just recently recommended this to Zara of the BookTube channel, Books with Zara. But that's no big surprise, because I recommend this fantasy trilogy to everybody, including you. Read it, and then come back and tell me what you think about it, please. Number 10, the oldest book I've read by publication date. So I'm going to stick with works of fiction here, because as far as my nonfiction reading goes, I do quite enjoy reading contemporary chronicles from people during various historical times who wrote about their experiences at the time. So I've read books that go all the way back to the 1300s, when I read the Chronicles of the Hundred Years' War, for instance. Or there's also at least one book I've read that goes back to the 1700s that's a look at the pirates of the age. So for the sake of answering this question, I'll stick with fiction. And when I started looking at the classics I've read, my third oldest book I've read was A Tale of Two Cities by Charles Dickens, which was written in 1859, or at least it was published in 1859. Second oldest was The Three Musketeers by Alexandre Dumas, which was published in 1844. And the oldest book, apparently, that I've read is Ivanhoe by Sir Walter Scott, published in 1819. Oh yeah, I guess I also didn't include religious writings, because the Bible goes back a few years too. And for better or worse, I've read through that tome. Before I go on to question 11, I just want to take a quick second to thank my Patreon supporters, especially my high-tier supporters, Joanna, Paul, and Mojo. Thank you so much for your help. Every dollar that you are sending in to me is very much appreciated. I certainly don't take it for granted. Now, question 11 is, newest book you've read by publication date? And as far as I can tell, that was The Light of All That Falls by James Islington, which is book 3 of the Lycanius trilogy. I made a video about that. Actually, I think that's the last video I uploaded, was an extensive review of this high fantasy series. But this was published in 2019, and as far as I can tell, I haven't read anything from 2020 or 2021 at this point. Question 12, favorite author. And I think I would have to say that Guy Gavriel Kay is my favorite author. He's a fantasy author who has some of the best books I've ever written. Like I said, The Fiona of Our Tapestry was the best high fantasy trilogy I've ever read. His duology called The Serentine Mosaic is amongst my top 10 favorite works of fiction ever. And there are other of his books that I've really enjoyed. There have been a few misses though, so not everything he writes I love. But enough of what he's put out has impressed me that I would probably call him my favorite author. Question 13, buying books or borrowing books? And I would definitely go with buying books there. When you borrow a book, you just never know what kind of person you're borrowing from, if they're one of those people who loves to keep their books in pristine condition. Although if they were, I don't know why they would be lending out books. But you know, when it comes to reading, I like to be as relaxed as possible and just have my own book in hand and enjoy the experience that way. Question 14 is a book you dislike that everyone else seems to love. One review I did that surprised me was a video about The Shadow of the Torturer by Gene Wolfe. I had no idea it was at all popular, but I think I've received more negative comments on that particular video than on any of my other videos. So apparently that one is a popular book that I did not enjoy. If I want to make myself even more enemies here, and no fantasy lover is ever going to watch any of my videos again after this, I don't think, but I would have to say that while I didn't necessarily dislike this trilogy, I really didn't like it all that much. And that is Mistborn by Brandon Sanderson. Easy with the comments, all right? It's just, it didn't hit for me, really. I understand that I'm in the tiniest minority there, that is a almost universally loved series, so don't take my word for it, whatever you do. But moving on from there as quickly as possible to number 15, Bookmarks or Dog Ears? What do you think I am, some kind of monster? Bookmarks. Question 16, a book you can always reread. This one is going to go back to a book that I showed earlier. I'm not really in the habit of rereading books just because my to-be-read list is massive, bigger than I'll ever get to in my lifetime. So there's always a new book I want to read. I almost never go back and reread a book. But one book I have gone back to reread, and I could see doing it even again, is Catch 22 by Joseph Heller. This is literally the funniest novel I've ever read. The second time I read through it, I took my highlighter so I could highlight passages from the book. And then I think I loaned that copy of the book to somebody and I never got it back. So then I had to go out and buy a new copy, which now I have to go back and reread and re-highlight at some point, I suppose. But I would also love to go back and reread a couple of my favorites, like The Brothers K or The Cider House Rules. It would be interesting to me to see if I enjoy those books as much as I did the first time I read them. Question 17. Can you read while hearing music? And I would say I don't put music on when I read, so I guess I don't necessarily know if I could or not. I just wouldn't want to. Mostly because the type of music I enjoy is punk rock music, so it's not necessarily the best kind of background while you're trying to concentrate on something else type of music. Question 18, one point of view or multiple points of view? Yes, as long as there are not too many points of view. I would say anywhere from 1 to 3 points of view is pretty much ideal from my reading perspective. Of course, a lot of fantasy books I've read do even more than that, but I start to get confused if I am following too many, so it's nice to keep it to between, I would say, 1 to 3 ideally. Question 19, do you read a book in one sitting or over multiple days? It's multiple days. I don't know if I've ever read a full novel in a single sitting. I don't think I ever have. By BookTube standards, I'm an incredibly slow reader. If I finish more than one book a month, that's a fast pace for me. So yes, definitely multiple sittings. And finally, question 20, who do you tag? And I tag you if you want to do this. I just always assume that no BookTubers actually watch my channel, so I don't bother to tag people. So if you are watching this and you want to do this tag, I encourage you to go ahead and do it. Cliffhangers are fine if they're leading into another book in the series. I don't want to end a book or a series on a cliffhanger if it's the last book in the series. But if there's another book or a book to follow it, why not have a cliffhanger? Wouldn't bother me any. Are there any questions here that got you thinking? If anything popped up, do comment below. I'd love to continue the discussion, and I always appreciate the time you take with me. The preceding video has been brought to you free of charge by me, Josh. The only thing I ask in return is that you could do one of the following. Give me a thumb up, push the subscribe button, or share the link to this video with somebody who you think would enjoy it. Cheers. Because, watch it. I mean, so for this, oh yeah, I guess I didn't also, this, are there any questions here that made you go,